Sunday roundup, and before we break for the evening with our two guests, Andrew Craig with the Justice Integrity Project in Washington, and John Edward Early, who heads up the McClendon Group at the National Press Club. John McLaughlin always does predictions at the end of his show, so let's break out the crystal ball here. Andy, you first. Who do you think, first of all, will be the Republican nominee? And who do you think will be sworn in as our next president on January 20th, 2013?
No, boy, you know, the McLaughlin group, they said it was unscripted. That doesn't mean they're unprepared.
Well, you know,
you've tossed me a live
unprepared
grenade here. I predicted a challenge a couple months ago to Obama from the Democratic wing of the Democratic Party.
Right.
I still think that it's going to manifest itself, but it's so slow doing so. I think ultimately he will probably be reelected because he actually serves the interests of many of the core Republican power brokers. Because, you know, if a Republican were doing the things that he's doing, the people would be in the streets against the president.
Absolutely. He's a great firewall. John, how about you? Who do you think? You think Obama's going to take it again? And who do you think the Republicans are going to, who's going to rise to the top there?
Well, you know, I think that Obama's, you know, he's got some pretty big-time money support, you know.
Right.
And of course, this is a little far out for him, you know. He can look kind of bad right now.
Right.
You know, getting a running start on being reelected. So I wouldn't count him out.
Yeah.
And I think on the Republican side, I think it's a very volatile situation on the Republican side, but I think that the corporate malleability of Pawlenty will pay off, you know.
Right, right.
Smooth, he's very smooth, and he's, you know, the corporate guys like him, and he can slip and slide all over the lot, you know.
Where you might say that the corporate money would line up behind Mitt Romney, apparently he's not all that well thought of over, believe it or not, the Republicans have moved so far to the right, Romney's thought of as a liberal by many of them. Who would have thought? And I think it's the Massachusetts, being Massachusetts governor, of course, has pretty much put a lot of baggage on him as somebody who isn't trusted amongst the extreme right wing of the Republican Party, which is now the Republican Party in all seriousness.
I agree with you. I think that baggage card is going to get lost before it takes flight.
Well, I want to thank you both for taking time out on a Sunday night to come on the program with all the technical problems and all that. And we'll have to try to do this again sometime in the future. I think the McLaughlin format works pretty well when you don't have Pat Buchanan yelling back at Eleanor Cliff. So thanks very much, and we'll see you both at the appointed place at the National Press Club.
We enjoyed it, and would love to get those listener questions, too, if we come back.
Okay, yes, absolutely. When we get our technical problems worked out, we'll do that. But thanks again for coming on, and this is Wayne Madsen. In the near future for another...